This is where it all began, and you would hardly know. Life in Wuhan is back to normal. Its people apparently carefree. The city is unrecognizable from January, when it was in the grip of a mystery disease, one that didn't yet have a name. Sky News was among the thousands caught in the chaos and confusion of the first ever lockdown, which prompted a mass evacuation. 7 months later, though, there are still questions. How did Wuhan become ground zero for the coronavirus? What did the Communist Party know and when? In China, those questions are asked only by the very brave. Zhao Lei's father fell ill at the end of January. There was no ambulance to take him to hospital, so his family set out to walk the 6 miles in the freezing cold before they were picked up in a local's tuk-tuk. It was too late. He died of respiratory failure as he sat in the emergency waiting room. Thousands here are grieving, but few would dare what Zhao Lei did next. She's suing the local government for compensation and for a public apology, fighting for what she believes is fair against a system that does not tolerate dissent. But the local courts have rejected her case. And the police have pressured Zhao Lei's mother to drop her lawsuit and to not speak publicly. Yang Jianqing is a legal consultant who fled China for the United States. He's working with an underground group of lawyers in China to help the families of Wuhan victims.
Here in Wuhan, a city that suffered so terribly, most people have gone back to life as it was before. But not everyone can. They want accountability, a full reckoning of what happened here in the early days of the pandemic.
The Chinese government has always insisted it has acted openly and transparently, and it has admitted some shortcomings and deficiencies in its early handling. But the national narrative now is one of triumph over
COVID-19.
Justice is one of China's 12 core socialist values, here on proud display. But it is hard to come by, when so many would rather forget. Tom Cheshire, Sky News, Wuhan.